Hi, and welcome to S'mores Hollow Farm. Today we're going to do a review of a 2017 Kawasaki Mule Pro FXT LE. If you're new to S'mores Hollow Farm, subscribe, like, comment. This is a new channel for us. We've had it for just a short while. We've had some older videos on there. So we'd like any of your comment, feedback, or questions on what we do here. We're going to try to slowly add videos. We're not going to be able to do it every week like some of these people do, but we'll try to do videos as much as we can and share our experiences on our small little farm. Went shopping, spent probably 6 months or so looking at the different models, different brands, and real quick rundown of why we chose this over the other ones. Can-Am, very expensive, had net doors. Did have some nicer features than this, like the dump was a little bit different, horsepower is a little bit more, price was a whole lot higher, so we stuck away from the Can-Am. The Polaris Ranger XP Crew, we liked it, my wife liked it, but again it had canvas doors, this had solid doors, and the dealer, a Polaris dealer, told us don't buy one because they're pieces of junk. They said you're going to be replacing bearings and all this stuff on it. So we didn't buy from them because they trash talk another unit, another brand that they do, and they were trying to sell us on this. And so we this through Ultimate Cycle in Powhatan, Virginia. And so I hope they don't mind, but I'm going to plug them in here. And Larry did really good at asking or answering a lot of my questions and listening to me ask a lot of questions and answering them all good. And they gave me a really good deal, and I felt pretty good about it. We also looked at the Massimos. We liked those. Those were a lot of features, get all this stuff on it, but it's still kind of a non-known yet company. The dealer network's kind of small. We do have an authorized service center, but again, it's just, you know, not too sure about it. And another big selling feature of this was the 3-year warranty. This is the only unit in the whole side-by-side that has a 3-year warranty on it. And so that was also good because, you know, we're not out there every day on it. We've had it now for a month, and I don't even think we have 20 hours on it yet. So let me go over the features real quick, make this a short, quick video, and then you can comment and ask questions that you want, and we'll try to answer as much as what we can. So we'll start here at the front. Four-wheel drive, differential lock in the back. It comes standard with at least a decent brush guard on it. It does have a skid pan for the diff. And we added the CV joint protectors up front. CV joints are expensive to replace. These weren't all that expensive, so we added it on. On the front up here, you have a small hood here, which has all of your radiator and electrical. I haven't gotten into this yet to really add anything. We'll probably add a work light in the back. But your radiator, electrical is up front here. Try to put this back right. There we go. All right, we added the mirrors. And because it's like driving a car. So it's nice having the mirrors to be able to look while you're trail riding, if you're working on the farm and crossing roads, going down the road for farm work, you can. It also came standard, the LE came standard with the aluminum wheels. The EPS did not, electric power steering did not. This one came standard with aluminum wheels. It also has electric power steering, which is nice. It also came standard with the canopy. And one of the biggest selling features for my wife and I, with having two smaller kids, was the doors. We like having these doors here. You know, I know it's not like having a full door here and a window and all that, but it makes you a little bit more secure when you're riding in. And also, I mean, we've been down a few trails around where we live, a lot of blackberry bushes. And if we would have had that canvas side on here, it'd have just torn that up. And you can see the scratches they've got in here. This is plastic, so it's gonna take a beating before it gives out. It's got six seating, and it's got over the shoulder seat belts for all six passengers. Inside the unit here, it does have, on the inside, It has a glove box, cup holders on either side. It has two power outlets here. And it also has two power outlets. The LE comes with the two power outlets in the back. So I've used that for putting my spray tank on and using that. It does have low, high, neutral, and reverse. It does have a hour meter and speedometer, fuel gauge, and two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive clock. Your hours, I got 20 hours on it. And let's see here, I've only ridden 125 miles so far. So it's not that many miles that we have driven with this unit. On the front end, it does have LED lights that come standard on the LE. Regular halogen, here's your four-wheel drive, two-wheel drive, and a rear differential lock. Here's your high-low. It does have an adjustable steering wheel. And a pull stick emergency brake. Okay. Spin around here to the back. The other thing that was kind of nice about it that we liked was the stadium seating. So if you look, the back seat and the front seat are a little bit off so that the people, when they're sitting in the back, get a little bit higher view and can see over. So when my kids are riding in the back, they're not looking completely in the back of our heads, but can see around. Your battery is in here with your air filter. It comes with a standard car battery, not your ATV batteries. It's a little bit bigger battery. Has a large alternator to power whatever you want on this. The bed does dump. It dumps in either the six-person configuration with a little bit of work on it, or you can extend this up and have a larger bed, which can hold a full-size pallet and carry 2,000 pounds when it's up in the three up instead of the six up. It's not that hard to do. To convert this over, I won't show you today because I want to make this a quick video, but if you want, make a comment and I'll go over on how simple it is. Polaris really knocks this, but in all given take of it all, if you're doing a lot of dumping, you'll get the unit that's good for you. We don't. Mostly ours is hauling stuff from the house down to the chicken coop, over to our neighbors, picking up wood. I mean, we're not a heavy duty utility, and we're not heavy duty sport, and this really fit a good mixture between what we did. Toward the back here, it does come standard with a trailer receiver, and so I've got a ball and on there for my trailer. It'll tow up to carry 2,000 pounds in the back, 2,000 pounds towing. It does have two handles on the tailgate, which lower down. Steel bed, plastic sides with metal corners, so it is pretty sturdy. It's got metal framing, metal here, so it's lightweight to get heavy duty. This mule weighs almost 2,000 pounds, so it is a small truck compared to a lot of others. It is heavy. The frame is a ladder frame. I got the also purchased the bumper for it to just kind of protect the back end CV joint. Protectors in the back. Why we like this, again, the price was, I think, pretty fair for the unit compared to others. We looked at the Polaris, the Can-Am, Honda. Hondas were nice, but the back seat folded up into the bed, you had no bed. And so, plus it was expensive. It has a neat transmission. It's a regular automatic transmission. So it's pretty neat. But this is why we bought it. We bought it because it's more utility than it is sport. But yet, if you want to get on it, and we do some trail riding around here, and it rides very nice. It's a very smooth ride. It's adjustable springs all the way around. It's quiet. You can have conversations, drive trail riding. And so far, yesterday we tried getting it stuck, threw a little bit of mud up inside the cab. My wife was not happy about that because it stunk, but we got it out, put it in full drive, diff lock, low gear, and that thing went right on through. If you got any questions, comments, please leave them below. Please subscribe, and we appreciate any of your comments. Thank you again for visiting Smores Hollow Farm.